Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about how to fix system and compressed memory, high CPU, RAM, and disk usage on Windows. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. You should start off by scanning your PC with anti-malware. You need to confirm that high CPU usage by system and compressed memory is not caused by malware that is lingering on your PC. Run the antivirus on your PC to check for the presence of malware and get rid of it. If the issue is caused by malware, it should be fixed after running antivirus or anti-malware. Run a system file checker. If high CPU, RAM, and disk usage by system and compressed memory task is caused by corrupted files or missing files in the file system, you can fix them by running the system file checker. To do this, open the command prompt as an administrator. Type in sfc space slash scan now, all one word, and hit enter. This might take a while. When it's finished, restart your system and see if it's fixed then. End system and compressed memory task. Since system and compressed memory task is using high CPU or RAM and disk, you'll need to end the process to stop the usage first. Open the task manager. Look for system and compressed memory and select end task. It should end the task and release the high usage of CPU, RAM, and disk. Optimize visual effects for better performance. There might be a chance that visual effects on your PC might have affected the system and compression memory on your PC. To do this, open the control panel. Click on All Control Panel Items and find System. Then go to Advanced System Settings. Under Advanced, under Performance, Visual Effects, click on Settings. You have the option between let Windows choose what's best for your computer, adjust for best performance, and adjust for best performance. You can also make customized choices. What you can do is try to let Windows choose what's best for my computer. If you're still having trouble, you can do for best performance and even remove some of the customization. Once you've made your choices, click on Apply and click OK. Change paging file size to automatic. The issue might have been caused during the change in paging file size. You'll need to change the custom values to automatic for the issue to be resolved. In the Start menu, search for Advanced System Settings. In the Performance section, click on Settings, go to Advanced. In the Advanced tab, you'll see Virtual Memory. Click on Change. In the Virtual Memory window, check the button besides Automatically Manage Page File Sizing for All Drives. Then click on OK. Also, if that does not work, you can also try disabling the paging file and size. In the Virtual Memory pane, uncheck Automatically Manage Page Filing Size and make sure that you click on No Paging File. Restart your system and see if that fixes the problem. You can try disabling SysMain. SysMain on Windows works to improve the system performance. There are some instances where the SysMain causes high disk usage by some processes, including system and compression memory. We'll need to eliminate that chance by disabling SysMain on your PC. It should fix the issue if that's the cause of it. To do that, open the Services Manager. Look for SysMain. Double-click on it to open Properties. Click on Stop to end the process. Make the startup type Disabled and then click on Apply and OK. Restart your system and see if the problem has been resolved. You can also try to disable system and compress memory task. If none of the others work, then you might have to disable the system and compress memory task. We'll have to do this in the task scheduler. So open a run box, type in taskschd.msc and click OK. Double click, open the task scheduler library, then find the Microsoft folder. Go to the Windows folder and scroll down to the Memory Diagnostic folder. You'll see Run Full Memory Diagnostic on the right hand side. Right click on it and select Disable from the context menu. Then close the task scheduler window and restart your system to see if the problem has been corrected. What's next would be to look at it in clean boot. You'll need to perform clean boot to find out the cause of the issue. If the high CPU, the RAM, or the disk usage by the system and compression memory task is caused by a third-party application, you can find it through clean boot. If the usage is the same on clean boot mode, you'll have to restore your PC to the point where everything was working fine, or repair your PC if there's no other restore point created. To do this, for more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.